Hello everyone, welcome back to my weekend updates. These last few weeks, I've been very hard at work on something that I'm super excited to show off. But right now, I'm in an older version of my engine because I just wanted to remind you guys of what the world size was like before. Previously, in the most recent release of my engine, I had a world which was 1024 by 1024 by 384 voxels. This is because the memory consumption of this world is super high. Each voxel is stored as an unsigned 32-bit integer. This means that the entire voxel volume takes up 1.6 gigabytes of data. We can see that if we open up Task Manager and go ahead to the Performance tab and check out the dedicated GPU memory usage. If I now go ahead and close the app, we'll see it immediately drop by that exact amount. So, what can we do to solve this? Well, what I've done is, as you would have seen before, implemented compression. However, what's new this time is that the compression algorithm is now run on the GPU. So let's take a look. If I now run my app, we can see it opens up and it's using only a fraction of that amount of memory. And the only reason that it's using any more than a negligible amount is because currently my GPU my allocator for the memory is over allocating. So we can see in here that the estimated VRAM usage is 433 megabytes, but I'm only using 200 megabytes on the heap. And this is actually an even overestimation because it's assuming that you will allocate more into chunks that already have allocations in them. And so if I were to turn that feature off, then you can see that this world only takes 72 megabytes. Disregard the fact that I am statically allocating a gigabyte of RAM, just in case. But back with the good allocator, let's go ahead and try and make some edits in the world. Oh, whoops. So if I start painting, you'll see that the memory consumption begins to change. So it's 199 megabytes, but if we start changing things, we can see that the memory consumption increases because it's dynamically allocating more memory. And this is done because I have compression. So the data is being compressed, and so therefore it has a variable size in its memory footprint. However, if I go ahead and change my brush to be a bit bigger, which means it'll exceed the size of the bounds that I have predefined it to be constrained in, we'll see that it starts deleting whole chunks. And when this happens, you'll see that the memory actually gets deallocated because the compression algorithm sees that regions are completely uniform and deallocates them. So you can see over here in the heap usage, it's at 196 megabytes, but as I hold down left mouse button and destroy everything, it drastically reduces down to now 60 megabytes. If I even place a bunch of stuff, it still stays at 60 megabytes because all of these regions are completely uniform, okay? It can even reduce memory consumption if you were to paint over regions that were previously non-uniform. So like these chunks here, turning them into uniform reduce the memory consumption. This all comes together to make it so that I can make my world size much larger. So, for example, I could double the world size on all axes to be 2048 by 2048 by 2048. And so now when I run it, we can see that the world is much larger and it's taking its time to generate the world, but all of this time is taken up by the noise generation function that I have, as opposed to the actual compression and allocation of the memory that is necessary. And you can see that the heap usage is 890 megabytes. This would actually be much lower if I wasn't over allocating. But yeah, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time.